In this video, we're going to see if Lovable can build us a game. So I've done videos in the past using tools like Bolt and Lovable to build like SaaS apps or websites or things like that. But I want to see how good it is at actually coding a platformer game. If you haven't used Lovable before, it's an AI tool that allows you to write what you want to create, and then it uses AI to actually generate the app that you want to build. So let's say I want to build a platformer game that has one main character who jumps on platforms, avoids enemies, and gets to the end of the level to win. So similar to a game like Mario for the original Game Boy. So I'm going to go ahead and click create, and let's see what Lovable is able to generate here. So I'm going to go ahead and pause the video while it does all of the initial setup, and then I'll meet you back once we have something to actually test out. So one thing that comes up sometimes when you're building Lovable is an error will come up. And then right underneath, there's going to be a button where you can just click try to fix. And I did that. So now it is working on resolving the error. So I'll pause the video again and let you know when there's something for us to test. All right. So this is what I see now. And I see kind of an outline for a game and a level with scores, but I don't actually see how I can play the game. So I'm going to say I see a blank page with score, lives, and a reset game button, but I don't see the game itself and I can't play it. So let's see what it does with that. So it's still not working. And what I did was take a screenshot of the page and tell the AI what I see. Sometimes I find this helps. So let's see if this actually solves it. All right, so we're making some progress. Now we have kind of a game interface, but it's still not really working. So if I hit start game, it just goes blank. So I'm going to say when I hit start game, the screen goes blank. Can you fix that so I can play once I hit start game? So let's see if this resolves it for us. All right. So it looks like it is actually working now. I can go up and down. I lost a lot because I hit the enemy. And if I go here, okay, so it just goes until I end and I win. Okay, great. So I'm going to say, great, now it's playable. Add a side-scrolling screen so I can end, make the level a lot longer to get to the end. Okay, so let's see how it does here with that update. All right, so now it says it features side scroll with a much longer level. So here we go. I can go and jump, and I'm supposed to avoid these little black boxes. And awesome, now it scrolls. Very cool. Let me jump up. Oh, it's actually a little bit tricky. See if I can do it. I don't know how long they made it. If I jump. There we go. Okay, awesome. Cool. And I got a score here. And let me just try again and test the lives. It looks like it's putting me at the end of the level automatically. Okay, cool. So overall, it's working, but I'm going to ask it for a couple more changes. After winning the level, could me generate a new level and let the player start again, make each level a bit more difficult. All right, so I'll do that. Let's let it generate that and I'll pause the video. All right, so now I'm playing the new game, which is supposed to, it's supposed to increase in difficulty each level. And I lost again, so it might be hard. I'm gonna pause the video and see if I can get to the end so you don't have to watch me do this. Okay, so I just beat the level. It's actually a lot harder than I was thinking the first time, but it's actually pretty fun, even though it is a little challenging. So I'm going to say I beat the level, but the next level didn't start right away. So let's see if it's able to fix that for us. Okay, so it says now it's going to keep the game working with the score intact once we beat the level. So let's see if I'm able to do this. It's actually a little bit tricky here. Oh, there we go. And not easy, not the easiest game. So I've tested this and gone to the end of the level. I'm not going to make you watch it again, but it does work and puts me onto the next level, and it gets progressively harder as we go. So other things that we could add to the game, we could add music. We could change the character so it's kind of better graphics. We could have different power-ups. There's a lot that we could add to this. We could also build in a database using Supabase. Check out our other videos on Lovable of how to add a Supabase to our app, which is basically adding a backend database. With this, you could add login. You could have people save their high scores. There's a lot that you could do if you connect a database to this game. You can also publish it and actually make it live for other people to play. So I could even do this and make it deploy it so that others could actually play the game themselves. So pretty cool. I'm actually pretty impressed with what it was able to do in a pretty short amount of time. And I think there's a lot more, if you wanted to play around with it more, that you could build on to the game. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video and seeing what's possible with Lovable. If you want to learn more about building with Lovable, Bolt, or other AI app generation tools, check the link in the description to go to our prompt to product community, which is a community that we're going to build. We have a wait list going right now to learn more about building with tools like this. Also, check out No Code MBA, which is a full learning platform teaching you how to build with no code and AI tools, with lots of self-guided courses that go from start to finish of how to build your own apps, websites, and automations. Thanks again for watching, and be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more content like this for free. We'll see you in the next video.